Alright guys, so this is an effect that I've been looking at for ages in Minecraft. I've had it on my back of my mind, you know, using like glass and ice as mirrors and kind of reflecting whole rooms, you know, taking up a lot of space on the other side. But I've never actually put it into practice, so this is the first time I've tried it, and I've also done a tutorial on it, so enjoy. So, before we begin, this is the build by Jericraft. There'll be links down below to everything, including his channel and his video where he did, where he talked about pretty much everything in here. So definitely go check them out, because this looks freaking great. So I've split up this tutorial in my mind, at least, into a few sections, because it's kind of it's quite precise on how to do it. Obviously you can do it by trial and error, but I've kind of figured out a way of doing it quite evenly. So first of all, we need to select our area, and this is probably the hardest step. So let's assume that you have a flat floor, because if you don't have a flat floor, then just fuck you, you're gonna have a hard time. We're gonna bring our selection block up a bit. We're not gonna select the floor, not like that. If you select the floor, then you're going to end up with a mirror that's not as good as if it will have like an extra block and it won't actually be correct. So I've selected my 2 points. I'm just going to get rid of these 2 reference blocks. And I've counted from this block here, it's 7 blocks till this archway. So the 7th block is here. So we're going to expand it by 7 blocks in every direction, because this room is symmetrical. So /expand 7, 7, 7, and 7. So this means we've got the entire kind of floor selected, and then we need to expand it up. Now I've counted this, it goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and then 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25 to select all the blocks. So we're going to go 25 blocks up. So I'm going to look up, expand 25. So that should have the entire room now selected. So now we're going to /copy. So we've got the whole room and clipboard. We're going to /flip. That's what's going to turn everything upside down. And then we're going to go down, all the way back down to the bottom. And then we're going to go an extra block. So we get down to the bottom and we go down one extra block. And that extra block is important. So we're 1 block lower than what we initially selected. And we're going to /paste. And hopefully we have everything. Yep, that worked perfectly. Okay, great. So let me just get rid of this snow, and then we'll start talking about what's just happened and why we did it like that. Okay, so I need to mend the chandelier a little bit. So what we've done is we've effectively made this the perfect amount of mirror. If there is a mirror line directly on this seam between the 2 blocks, then this is completely correct. Now, what the problem we would have had before is we'd have ended up with this. And this effectively means that the mirror is 1 block thick, which is it's true in terms of Minecraft, but it wouldn't look right. It wouldn't look like a real mirror. So we want these 2 blocks to touch. So obviously our mirror is going to go on this bottom block. So from below it won't look like a good mirror, but from top it will look like a perfect mirror, which is exactly what we're after. Also, if you're going to use torches and stuff, these will flip upside down, and that is fine. But you're also going to need to, if you've got something like a chandelier, you need to place back down the torches, and you place them the wrong way up. Well, people will notice, but there's really no way around this. Obviously, a way around it is using glowstone in your builds, because glowstone will work the same either way up, which would be ideal. And there are ways of kind of putting in the torches the wrong way up, so they're hovering in midair, but ain't nobody got time for that. I'm not going to bother with that bottom ring, no one will notice. So when we've got that, there's a few more little things we need to do to fix stuff. You can see I've got some snow here, and we're going to do that over here as well. In fact, no, we're not. We're actually going to use ice. I'll show you why in a second, but we're going to pop ice in this gap here. Let's do this. There we go. I'm just going to do it to all the others as well, so we'll be back in a second. Okay, I actually changed my mind, because these are really not finished yet. There's going to be stuff behind here, so we don't need to worry about that just yet. But you can see we've got... Oh, I missed a bit. I missed a bit, guys. Oh, dear. Oh, dear, oh, dear. There we go. So now we need to add in our ice floor. And you can do this more precisely, but I'm just going to use a brush because I'm lazy. And we're going to go brush, cylinder, then we're going to go ice, size of 10, and then mask of air so that we don't fuck anything up. And we're going to click on the bottom of the 2 blocks, so like that. Excellent. And then we're going to drag this all the way around, and I will quickly talk about why this mirror effect looks so good, and then that'll be the end of the video. So as you can see, this looks freaking fantastic. It looks absolutely brilliant. We've got this great mirror going on. You can see where I put the ice, it's actually gone black. You can use white wool in there, which makes it which also it kind of makes the effect look better. Obviously, if you want the best effect though, you're going to need to copy all the way out to there. Basically, everywhere that you can see from this side, you need to be able to see down there as well. But that's going to be a problem because we've got sunlight out here and you can't replicate sunlight down below. So we're not going to do that because it won't work. But you can see what kind of thing we're going for. So the reason why this mirror looks so great, especially on a bigger scale, is because we have this torch low down and close to the mirror. It creates a pool of light around on the floor, like here. And what's great about the pool of light is that it doesn't let through as much of the reflection, just like in a real mirror does. So over here you can see straight down, and over there you can't really see as much. And that is exactly what happens, like if you look across a lake, you can look straight down into the clear lake and you can see the bottom. But if you look a long way away, because of the choppiness and the slight little rough bits in the mirror surface, then it kind of messes up the image, so you can't see the reflection. And that's what makes it look so good on a big scale. Yeah, so I think that's all I've got to this tutorial. You can of course use glass. Glass won't look nearly as nice though, because this mirror has got a brilliant finish, although the kind of sliding around in it thing is quite annoying, so I recommend putting kind of paths across and stuff, but you can all work that out on a kind of build specific basis. So go check out Jerocraft's stuff, it's going to be in the description. If you like this, then please don't forget to leave a rating on the video, maybe share this around to people who have not seen this effect before, get this video a bit viral, you know what I mean? Yeah. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you next time.